Yesterday, one of the greatest jazz legends of all time, Jimmy Cobb, passed away at the age of 91. He was the drummer that played on the biggest and most famous jazz recording, Kind of Blue, with Miles Davis, of all time. That record, which featured Miles on trumpet, John Coltrane on the tenor sax, Julian Cannonball Adderley on the alto sax, Wynton Kelly on the piano on this song, and Paul Chambers on the bass. 1988, I got a chance to meet Jimmy Cobb, which was at the New School in Manhattan, New School for Social Research. I taught there for a semester. I was teaching a contemporary music course, and I heard that Jimmy Cobb was teaching on one of the days I was there. So I went down to the room where he was teaching an ensemble. I looked through the window and I saw Jimmy Cobb, and I thought to myself, can't believe it. Jimmy Cobb is here. So I waited until the class was over and I went in and I was introduced to him, and I said, I'm such a massively big fan of you. And he was so nice. But I couldn't really, I just couldn't imagine that he is the guy on this record. He's on Kind of Blue. But he was also on other records. He was on Sketches of Spain, another Miles record that is a classic. If you don't know Sketches of Spain, you need to check it out. This is a record that is just absolutely beautiful, mind-boggling how beautiful this record is. Jimmy played drums on this. He played drums on this record. This is Wes Montgomery Full House, which came out in 1962. It's a live record, basically with Miles Davis's rhythm section. Wynton Kelly, Paul Chambers in the bass, Wes, and Johnny Griffin on the saxophone. Oh man, it's so. Let's see Wes here. Where is it? Oh wait, this is Johnny Griffin's solo. This is the most insane sax solo, but listen to Jimmy. Oh man. So good! And then, of course, with Wes. Here's Wes. Oh, so good. Let's say it right. Right here. Oh, I mean, smoking. That's Jimmy Cobb playing on that. So when I'm meeting him, I'm thinking he played on that record. He played on Full House. Not only did he play on Full House, but he played on this record too. This is the Boss Guitar, which came out in 1963. This is with Mel Rhine on the organ, Wes on guitar, and Jimmy Cobb. This is called Fried Pies. Listen to that ride. Oh, such feel. That's Jimmy Cobb. So I'm meeting the guy and thinking, he's on that. This is him. If you don't know the Boss Guitar, it's the greatest jazz guitar record of all time. Unless, of course, you talk about Full House or this one, which is Smokin' at the Half Note. another West record. This is the tune No Blues. This has one of the greatest chord solos of all time. But who's on drums? You can play like that if you get Jimmy Cobb playing behind you. No, if you're Wes Montgomery. Listen to those chords. Oh! Jimmy Cobb, Wes, this is so good. He's playing, that's a chord solo, it's like a sax section. He played on Wayne Shorter's debut record. This is a tune called Black Diamond. This came out in 1959. Wayne Shorter from Weather Report, from Miles Davis's 1960s quintet. So good. That's Lee Morgan on the trumpet. Lee Morgan played on John Coltrane's Blue Train record, for those of you that know that record. But he's playing on this. The records that Jimmy Cobb was on, he recorded with Billie Holiday. She died in 1959. He recorded with John Coltrane, who died in 1967. Wes, who died in 1968. Wynton Kelly, piano player, died in 1971. Lee Morgan died in 1972. Paul Chambers in 1968. All these people, these legends. Paul Chambers, 1969. These legends, he played with all of them. And he was a legend. And I thought it was important to pay tribute to Jimmy Cobb, my favorite jazz drummer of all time. He had an incredible career and was playing until recently. And he should be honored. And for those of you that don't know these records, I'll put the names of them in my in the description below, and you can check out the genius of Jimmy Cobb. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Rick Beato.